So today we want to concentrate on professionalizing our consultancy business. And of course, in the consultancy or professional services, we are talking of all manner of kinds. I've seen many of you have already indicated nutritionists, we have accountants, we have lawyers, we have engineers, we have management consultants, all of them. Today, we shall look at it in a general way. There are instances we have managed to invite training for specialized areas. So you can give a training to pharmacists, we can give a training to lawyers and so on. If you'd like us to do that, please, that is one of the things we'd be happy to see you tell us other things we can do for you. So one of the key things in professional service is to see basic challenges that are more or less natural in the nature of the business. Businesses are intangible. It is not like selling a good. It is not like making a customer see the good before they buy. Unfortunately, they have to judge the nature of your service before you have provided. And it is because of that, the way you approach become critical. We say it is important to tangibilize the service. How does the service look before the customer gets it? Because unfortunately, customers know that at the end of the service, it's already done. You don't want a situation where people are in doubt what's the service they're going to get. Tangibilize the service. The environment in which you provide the service, the manner in which you provide the service, the manner in which you approach the customers or become people. It's about people. Services are provided by people, provided by you as the consultant, provided by your staff, some of whom are consultants like you, so they are actually providing the service with you, though they be employed. And some of them are actually working for you, not providing the service, but they are the entry through which the service is seen. You are running a law firm and you have a clerk. You are running a medical practice and you have a receptionist. These are the people they meet before they meet you. And they judge the nature of the business before they have even seen you. It is very, very important that you know the client is the owner, right? Satisfy them and of course provide leadership. Okay, there are certain forces that you need to cope with. For instance, there are professional code of ethics, right? Well, ethics can be a general term, but when you're looking at in the service of professional consultancies, there usually will be a code of ethics. And if there isn't, especially if you're practicing a general area, you want to create your own. Of course, there are many expectations of clients, and sometimes they change along the way. The client said this at the beginning, and by the middle, they have already changed. And by the time, there needs to be clarity, but satisfy the client's expectation, whatever the circumstance. Okay? And then you realize there's increased competition, particularly now with technology. People are able to do the things that you do, probably not necessarily near you, so we might not even notice the nature of the competition, right? The digital competition, no? The online competition. Right, and also we must accept numbers are growing. Which profession now would you say is almost saturated? There are enough in the market, right? So much so that sometimes you realize that people are putting some kind of barriers to entry, right? So as to reduce the numbers. And if you are in that area, I know this is one of the challenges. I've met many people who say, I'm already qualified, but the entries are made so stringent, it becomes difficult. It might be good to understand the road to profitability, even as we do all these kind of things. And the road to profitability has two elements, revenue and costs. And it is when revenue exceeds costs that profit happens. And we must strategize then to make revenue happen, to increase the revenue, okay, to raise the revenue. And when you think about services, there are many times I find people would have questions like, wait a minute, I find myself doing a lot of work, but I don't know where the money goes. It's very, very important to move with strategy. What are the services that we are providing? Why are we providing those services? What difference are we making for the customer? Okay. Now, how long does it take for us to do the service? Look at it as a project from entry to exit. Every client is a project from entry to exit. What are the activities in between that are required to be done? Okay. So that we can improve utilization. But above all, you must capture the work done so that we can invoice accordingly. Now, I noticed somebody saying, how do I price? I know pricing is a tough subject. I train about pricing of products and services. If you want, I can send you notes, because it's a whole other kind of topic. I can send you notes on what we have done before. And when we invite this with Moses, feel free to join us. But the key thing you want, first of all, to notice is, what work have I done for the client? In some sectors, prices are regulated. In some sectors, it is an open-ended. It is, you might need to do negotiation with a customer. It's very, very important to know how others are charging. Sometimes there is a kind of wisdom in the market. The market knows how to set itself sometimes. So what prices are other people charging? And also, you have to recognize yourself. What is your value in the market? I would say my value per hour is a certain amount. So when I look at the work I'm going to give you, this is where the billing comes in. The work I'm going to give to you, it is going to be, say, 60 man hours. And 60 man hours, if I charge a thousand, then it becomes 60,000. That's the kind of thing you want to do. You ought to have a price of your own. In some sectors, the price of a person is already settled, or the range within which, your prices come in. And some of you who deal with customers that cut across regions, they usually have a certain approach. They might actually even make you understand what your price is a lot more than anybody else, because they have dealt with this in different sectors. So they'll tell you, say, at this level, the range is about $1,000 per day. Then you're saying, well, if I'm going to do 5 days, then that is going to be $5,000. Okay? So it's very, very important to have clear processes of how the job is going to be done. Dedicated sales and delivery roles. Once we have gotten the customers, again, it's very, very important we have clear procedures of how the work is going to be executed, so that we know when we're billing, we did A, B, C, D. That is what we're billing for. And if the customer would like to know what the basis of the price we're charging, then we are able to capture that. It is very important to invest in high talent among ourselves. We keep updating, we keep training. The market is brutal, right, in almost every area, because particularly of changes in technology. So that means you want to keep updating yours and also that of your staff. I know there is always a challenge in our field of consultants. You train people, and then the next question might be, wait a minute, are they still your workers, or they become your competitors? And that's another thing you want to think about, the governance structure of your consultancy. So we maintain, okay? It's very, very important to demonstrate value. What is the value we are giving, okay? And of course, because of that, we create references. I think what you would agree, one of the best marketing approach of professional business is referrals. I think most of the clients I get are usually through referrals. Okay. Now, revenue requires you capture the work done, hours and the rates, billing, do it on time, do it with clarity to avoid backlash later on when the job has been done. Then, of course, on the other side is the cost. What does it involve to do the business? Okay. Now, particularly at a time like this one, where we have a crisis, public crisis, number of customers have gone.